Designed in response to the F-16 American fighter, the MiG-29 of the Russians presented a formidable threat to Western pilots. So who do you think is better between these two fighter jets? Let's compare between the two, and before jumping right into it, don't forget to hit that bell and subscribe button so you can become a part of our notification squad. The General Dynamics F-16 Fighting Falcon is a single-engine supersonic multirole fighter aircraft originally developed for the United States Air Force. While the Mikoyan MiG-29, also known as Fulcrum, is a twin-engine jet fighter aircraft designed in the Soviet Union and now mainly used by the Russian Air Force. The F-16 was developed by General Dynamics and is designed as an air superiority day fighter, and it evolved into a successful all-weather multirole aircraft, while the MiG-29 was developed by the Mikoyan Design Bureau as an air superiority fighter during the 1970s, and it was developed to counter new US fighters such as the McDonnell Douglas F-15 Eagle and the General Dynamics F-16 Fighting Falcon. Firstly, let's look into the unit cost. The Fighting Falcon's unit cost is $18.8 million, whereas the MiG-29 is just a little expensive compared to the Fighting Falcon, having a cost of about $22 million. The dimensions of both these fighters does not vary too much. When it comes to length and wingspan, the F-16 is just 2 meters less than the MiG-29. Their height are almost the same, but the wing area of the MiG-29 is 38 meters square, which is 10 meters square larger than the Fighting Falcon. The empty weight of the F-16 measures 8,573 kilograms, whereas the MiG-29 measures 11,000 kilograms. The Falcon has a less gross weight when it comes to maximum takeoff weight, but it is a bit higher compared to its rival. The Fighting Falcon is powered by single Pratt & Whitney F100 PW229 or a General Electric F110 GE129 afterburning turbofan engine. The F-100 PW229 develops a thrust of 29,160 pounds force, whereas the F-110 GE129 generates a power of 29,500 pounds force. While the MiG-29, on the other hand, has two widely spaced Klimov RD-33 turbofan engines, each rated at 11,200 pounds force dry and 18,300 pounds force in afterburner. The space between the engines generates lift, thereby reducing effective wing loading, hence improving maneuverability. The engines are fed through intake rams fitted under the leading edge extensions, which have variable rams to allow high Mach speeds. So with the power and engine that has been mentioned, it ensures the speed of MiG-29 to travel at 2,778 km per hour, which is a little higher than the Falcon. The ferry range of the Falcon nearly doubles that of the MiG-29, and it also has more combat radius. Coming to service ceiling, the MiG-29 can fly at a maximum altitude of 18,000 meters, while the Falcon can fly at 15,000 meters. The F-16 can climb at a rate of 250 meters per second, which is less than the MiG-29. The F-16's incredible maneuverability is achieved by its relaxed stability design. The airframe is inherently unstable as the center of mass and lift are much closer together than on other designs, however this allows the aircraft to respond quickly to pilot control input and with tighter maneuvers. The F-16 has 1.095 thrust to weight ratio and its airframe can sustain plus 9 Gs. While the MiG-29 is super maneuverable, it can execute maneuvers impossible with regular aerodynamic controls because of its excellent handling characteristics following a stall. It can also attain very high angles of attack. The MiG-29 can even outperform the light-footed F-16 in both instantaneous and sustained turns. Now coming to armament. The F-16s could be armed with up to 6 AIM-9 Sidewinder heat-seeking short-range air-to-air missiles by employing rail launchers on each wingtip. More recent versions support the AIM-120 AMR-AAM. The aircraft can carry various AAMs, a wide variety of air-to-ground missiles, rockets or bombs, electronic countermeasures, navigation, targeting or weapon pods, and fuel tanks on 9 hardpoints, 6 under the wing, 2 on wingtips and 1 under the fuselage. It can carry AGM-65 Maverick, AGM-88, AGRM, AGM-158 joint air-to-surface down-off missile. The F-16 carries a 20mm M61A1 Falcon cannon for close-range aerial combat and strafing. The 20mm cannon is mounted inside the fuselage to the left of the cockpit. Armament for the MiG-29, however, includes a single GSH-30 30mm cannon in the port wing route. It is equipped with 7 external weapon hardpoints, and the aircraft can carry up to 2 R-27 air-to-air medium-range missiles, 6 R-73 and R-60 air-to-air short-range missiles, 4 pods of S-5, S-8, S-24 unguided rockets, air bombs weighing up to 3,000 kg, and 30mm built-in aircraft gun with 150 rounds of ammunition. F-16 avionics systems include a highly accurate enhanced global positioning and inertial navigation system. It also has a warning system and modular countermeasure pods to be used against airborne or surface electronic threats. The F-16CD is equipped with the Northrop Grumman AN/APG-68 multi-mode fire control radar. The APG-68 has greater range and resolution as well as 25 operating modes including ground mapping. The F-16EF, however, is fitted with Northrop Grumman's AN/APG-80 active electronically scanned array radar. The 16CD aircraft can be equipped with a lantern targeting system. The altitude navigation and targeting infrared for night systems from Lockheed Martin allows the F-16 to fly at low altitudes, at night and in any weather conditions to attack ground targets. The lantern system gives the F-16 extra accuracy for weapons delivery and consists of 2 pods attached to the exterior of the aircraft. The baseline MiG-29, on the other hand, is equipped with an information and fire control radar system comprising an N019 radar developed by Phasotron Research and Production Company, Moscow, an infrared search and track sensor, a laser range finder, and helmet-mounted target designator. The latest upgraded aircraft offered the N010 Zook-M, which is a planar array antenna rather than a dish, improving range and a much superior processing ability with multiple target engagement capability and compatibility with the Vimpel R-77. If the two fighters are facing towards each other at medium distance or let's say 40 miles apart, the F-16 will have an advantage as it slightly has a better radar and avionics compared to the MiG, hence the MiG-29 will be detected first. But in case of dogfight or in a close combat, the MiG-29 has an advantage because of its super maneuverability. Apart from all this, pilots play a major role here, like their level of tactical planning on how to engage with opposing aircraft. The actual response and the stress of actual combat determines the result of the engagement. So, what do you guys think? Please leave your thoughts in the comment section below, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.